Up from October 22, 1998, from that evening until today, I haven't taken any more hard drugs. No heroin, no cocaine, no tablets, nothing.
Gar nichts. Ja, mit circa 17 Jahren.
When I was about 17, my then boyfriend, who later became my husband, and I were invited by an acquaintance to smoke a joint.
Wir haben dann mitgeraucht. Und es ist dann so weitergegangen, wir haben dann
we all smoked together, and then it went on like that. We saw him again a couple of times and were invited back. Then we started to buy it ourselves, at first usually 10 grams, which we smoked on the weekends. One then meets more and more people who also take drugs, and you find out about all sorts of things. I then started taking LSD trips, speed, cocaine, and pills mixed with alcohol, as well as heroin. When I think about it now, I can't think of any drug, be it ecstasy or anything else, that I didn't take. Really, I took every drug you can imagine, psychedelic mushrooms, the whole lot.
Alle Drogen quer durch die Bank, halluzinogene Pilze, einfach wirklich alles. Ich habe dann eben schon durch die ganzen Drogen.
Because of the drugs, because I took them for so many years, I started getting pain in my joints. And because of this pain, I went to see a doctor who gave me acupuncture. At the doctor's practice, I saw a flyer, Healing on the Spiritual Path through the Teaching of Bruno Gröning, an invitation to a medical information lecture. The lecture was on October 22, 1998. The lecture was over, we were driving home, and in the car I suddenly had the thought, now you will stop smoking pot. And I told my brother, you know what, I'm going to stop smoking pot. And he replied very shortly, yes, yes, Andrea, I've heard that before. Something like that. Of course, he had known me for the last 18 years not being able to go without drugs. Well, that's what happened. From October 22, 1998, from that evening until today, I haven't taken any more hard drugs. No heroin, no cocaine, no tablets, nothing.
Gar nichts.
Und das, was für mich medizinisch auch so
what I find medically so important and interesting is, she had no physical withdrawal symptoms. Normally, after decades of drug abuse, there are physical withdrawal symptoms. With her, this didn't happen.
Dieser Bericht ist so etwas Besonderes von der Frau Mattelschweiger, weil er wieder
this report of Ms. Mattelschweiger is special because it can't be explained medically nor psychologically. This healing should not have happened the way it did. She should have had withdrawal symptoms after the lecture that would subside after 2 or 3 weeks. Psychologically, it can't be explained because she didn't have any withdrawals and didn't have any treatment. That doesn't free you either.
Sie war hochgradig abhängig. Und dann ist sie spontan.
She was extremely addicted. And then she spontaneously was freed through taking in this Heilstrom. Through going to the lecture, even though she was stoned when she was there, and she has stayed free. It's been 10 years now. For me, this can't be explained or understood psychologically. I remember reading the healing on the computer, mouth open and staring at the screen for a long time. I didn't know what to think. And it's the same today. I just can't explain it.
Und genauso stehe ich heute da. Ich kann das nicht erklären.
Heute geht's mir richtig gut. Ich fühle mich.
I'm doing very well. I simply feel free. I can enjoy my life again. Can just go into town, sit and have a drink without worrying where my next fix will come from. I just feel like a healthy young person. Just full of the joy of life. So happy that I can enjoy my life again.
Die Freude wieder. Ich kann mein Leben wieder genießen.